What if I told you that you could run a high-powered Linux server absolutely free, forever, no strings attached? That's right. I've been using one for over 4 years now, and it's been an absolute game-changer. It's a fully functional server with 24 gigabytes of RAM, 4 CPUs, and 200 gigabytes of storage, and I haven't paid a single cent. Let me show you exactly how I'm doing this, so you can set one up for yourself. We've all faced that moment when free trials run out. You sign up for AWS or Google Cloud, enjoy the benefits of their trial period, but then you're hit with monthly fees you weren't ready for. It's frustrating, and I was in that same boat years ago. But during my search for an alternative, I stumbled upon something incredible, Oracle Cloud. They offer what they call always free resources, and let me tell you, this isn't some watered down, barely usable free tier. This is the real deal. Unlike free trials that eventually expire, Oracle's free tier is forever. They give you powerful specs, 24 gigabytes of RAM, 4 CPUs, and 200 gigabytes of storage, completely free. That's more than enough to host a backend, run databases, or even experiment with more resource-intensive projects. It's reliable, has no hidden charges, and is perfect for developers who need a stable environment without breaking the bank. I've used it for personal projects, testing, and even some production-level tasks. And it's never let me down. So, how do you get started? First, head to signup.oraclecloud.com. You'll need a working email address and a credit card for verification purposes, but don't worry, you won't be charged. Fill out the sign-up form, verify your email, and provide your details. It's a straightforward process, and Oracle's interface guides you through each step. Once you've completed the sign-up, you'll gain access to your Oracle Cloud dashboard. This is where the magic happens. Now, here's where it gets even better. I know this process can seem a little overwhelming if you're new to cloud computing or Linux servers. That's where Cyberflow's Academy comes in. Imagine having access to not just one guide like this, but an entire vault of in-depth courses on web hacking, reverse engineering, bug bounties, and full ethical hacking, all taught by someone who's been in the trenches. Plus, I'm in the community every day, answering your questions directly. Whether you're stuck on SSH or trying to secure your server against attacks, I've got you. Oh, and there's a 51% affiliate program if you want to spread the word and make money while you learn. So why just set up a free server when you can learn how to make it bulletproof and hack like a pro? Head to Cyberflow's Academy today. First link in the description. Now, let's create your free instance. From the dashboard, navigate to Compute and then select Instances. Click the Create Instance button, and you'll see various options to configure your server. Here's the key. Always look for options marked as Always Free. For the operating system, I recommend selecting Ubuntu. It's versatile, widely supported, and easy to use. Adjust the image and shape settings to match the free tier specifications. Before finalizing, you'll need to download your SSH keys. These keys are essential for connecting to your server later, so make sure you save them securely. Finally, attach the boot volume, which can go up to 200 gigabytes, and click Create. The system will take a few minutes to spin up your instance, but once it's done, you'll have your very own free server ready to go. Accessing the server is just as easy. You'll use the SSH keys you downloaded earlier to log in. If you're unfamiliar with SSH, don't worry, it's simpler than it sounds. Open your terminal and type the command ssh-ipath to the server key Ubuntu at your public IP. Hit enter, and just like that, you're inside your server. It's all yours. You can install software, host applications, set up databases, whatever your projects demand. A quick tip, if you encounter any issues during this process, such as trouble connecting via SSH, double check that you've set up your keys correctly and are using the correct IP address. For added security, consider enabling a firewall or using tools like fail-to-ban to protect your server from unauthorized access. Regular backups are also a good practice to avoid losing any important data. And that's it. You now have a powerful server at your fingertips completely free for as long as you need it. If you found this guide helpful, don't forget to like and subscribe. I've got plenty more tips and tricks for developers, so stay tuned. And hey, if you want to dive deeper into this stuff, check out Cyberflow's Academy, where I share detailed courses and resources to take your skills to the next level. Happy hacking!